Elon Musk has unveiled Grok 3, which beats all the existing AI models in certain benchmarks. So we had this live session few minutes ago, and we had this setup with Elon Musk himself being there along with the lead engineers of Grok, quite similar to OpenAI's live events. This is the first chart that they showed comparing the MMLU score and the year of launch. And I really find it interesting because they are only comparing only OpenAI's model along with XAI's model. For example, here it's GPT-2, GPT-3, GPT-3.5, and they're literally saying Grok AI took very less time when compared to OpenAI to achieve the same level of accuracy. And next, he's showing this big training data center in which they have used a total of 200,000 H100 NVIDIA GPUs. So Elon Musk said this was like a leftover factory and he just took over it and he has built this big training farm. So as you can see here, the phase one was for around 122 days and they had around 100,000 GPUs, and the next 92 days they had to expand to another 100,000 GPUs, which puts a total of 200,000 GPUs at a single place. That's insane. And next is the benchmarks. So Grok not only has Grok 3, but it also has a Grok 3 mini, quite similar to OpenAI strategy, having O1 mini, O3 mini, something like that. And it has literally bet all the secondary models of top organizations. For example, Grok 3 and Grok 3 mini is better than DeepSeek V3, GPT-4o, Claude 3.5 Sonnet in math, science and coding. And in terms of this chatbot arena, Grok literally comes at top, beating all the existing models out there. So in this, basically they give a blind test for all the existing models on various categories, and Grok has managed to score 1400 points, and this is the first time any model has crossed this benchmark. Not even DeepSeek's R1 or O3 mini has achieved this score. And next is the reasoning plus time to compute, because Grok 3 is a reasoning model, it will think before giving you the answer. And here we are having direct comparisons between the top models, which is O3 mini high, O1 and DeepSeek R1. And here also you can see Grok is outperforming or equivalently performing to all the top models in the same benchmark. And basically the shaded portion means if you give more time for the Grok model, the better accurate results that it will give. So that's what the shaded portion refers over there. And this is the user interface of Grok. Many of you are thinking Grok can be only accessed via Twitter, Twitter's website or Twitter's app, but Grok has a separate website itself, quite similar to ChatGPT. It's grok.com, and here they will be having three new options, which is Deep Search, Think and Big Brain. And if you enable the Think option, it's basically Grok 3 mini. And if you enable Big Brain, it will enable the Grok 3 model, and both are thinking models, so it will think quite a lot before giving you the response. And next is the deep search feature, which is a web searching AI agent of Grok. This is quite similar to ChatGPT's deep research. Basically, if you give a prompt, it just goes to the web and searches everything. I don't think it's quite similar to OpenAI's operator feature. This is kind of like searches the web and gives you the answer. As you can see here, it has gone through a lot of steps and serves multiple number of web pages and then gives you the response. And I don't think it's quite similar to OpenAI's operator. And next important question is, who can use Grok 3 model? At the moment, the premium plus users of Twitter can use Grok 3. And we also have another feature called as Super Grok. And I think this costs around $40 per month to use. And finally, Elon Musk also said about open sourcing Grok 2. He said once Grok 3 model is stable, which will happen in another few months, he will completely open source Grok 2. So that's pretty much, guys. Can't wait to see the comparison between DeepSeek R1, O3 mini as well as Grok. It's going to be amazing. Please let me know what you think in the comments. I hope you have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools, Gemini AI, ChatGPT, Sora, OpenAI APIs and stuff. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.